we built a product which was for the community, by the community. We were building an ecosystem which was used to tell you that who is the person behind the unknown number.
Hi. Truecaller has some amazing numbers, 150 million downloads and 100 million DAU without any marketing spends. What is the secret sauce?
Thank you for having me here. It's an honor and a pleasure to be here. As you rightly said, we have 100 million daily active users in India, which means we have such a huge, large base and users use us multiple times during the day. We are a big household brand in India now. What led to such a huge success in the country was we built a product which was for the community, by the community. We were building an ecosystem which was used to tell you that who is the person behind the unknown number, right from where you are getting a call, and by which we give context about the call, whether this call is coming from a friend, whether this call is coming as a spam. And in that manner, we are able to solve a lot of spam problems for you, and we save a lot of time in hand.
Yeah. Okay. What is the revenue model today?
So we started with our monetization strategy around 4 years ago. We have multiple fold revenue model. Our primary source of revenue is actually through advertising, followed by premium subscription. So brand marketers can actually market their brands on Truecaller. And for premium subscriptions, our 150 million users can actually buy the premium subscription, which has got certain features like call recording, you know, checking your checking profiles, and an ad-free environment.
How have you innovated on the advertising monetization front? Tell us about the new opportunities there.
Interestingly, yeah. So in India, we started monetizing the app in 2016. And just to give you a little flavor of what we bring uniquely to the table, the first is we are a non-appointment viewing app, right? What does that mean? So we are a passive app which is used by a consumer at least 8 to 9 times a day. So a brand marketer can actually talk to that consumer multiple times during the day. The second is we provide an extremely brand-safe environment to the marketers to feature their brands. Third is we are 100% programmatic, right? So everything happens in an automated world. Fourth is that our users have data and smartphones, right? So we are giving very affluent audience to our marketers. These are the differentiating factors that has led to the success of advertising business in the country.
How are brands using Truecaller? Can you give us some examples?
Sure. So in 3 years, we have evolved as a platform, right? We now solve for full funnel marketing solutions for marketers. So to help meet objectives like top of the mind, brand recall, we have 100% share of voice solutions, which can help you target the entire 100 million daily active users every day. We can help you solve the middle funnel matrix by helping you target the right message to the right audience at the right time. And to the lower funnel matrix, we can address it by click-to-call or easy lead solutions, right? So as the platform has evolved, we have now catering to all the three stages of the funnel. And to give you some examples, Vivo has been a strong advertiser with us over the last 3 years. And what they have seen is, when they have engaged with the users of Truecaller, their engagement rates are increasing. Their cost per reach have actually gone down, right? So that's a phenomenal case study for a new Bharat. OLX Cash My Car did a campaign with us where they got 45% actually lower click-to-call ratio. These are some of the brands which has addressed the new Bharat. But for the modern age India, right, Spotify leveraged Truecaller when they were launching in India. So it's a Swedish brand. They wanted to target the affluent consumers of India. So we helped them reach out to the 100 million daily active users. Plus, we helped them reach out to the music lover category, which we had.
Last question. Tell us a bit about Tejinder outside of the workplace.
Oh, great. I think that's a tough one. I travel almost 3 times a week. Not 3 times a week, in fact, 3 weeks in a month. I get very little time to spend with the family. So the weekends plus few days when I'm here, I think I love to spend time with my 5-year-old princess. I think that takes up the priority. Taking them out for a nice drive, enjoying a McDonald's burger with her. I think that is what I enjoy the most when I'm not doing work. And I think sometimes just taking off for my me time, you know, taking a walk without the smartphone in your hand or without listening to music, I think that gives me peace.